Hello and welcome to these Chorley District Reflections, a look at Armistice and Remembrance Sunday, and the impact that conflict has had on the people of Chorley District. Just as we acknowledge the 75th anniversary of VE Day in May and VJ Day in August, we will turn our attention to all service personnel who have served from Chorley District. The Armistice of World War I came into effect at 11 a.m. on the 11th of November 1918. The guns fell silent on the Western Front. The Great War was over. Ever since then, the nation has used that anniversary to come together and observe a 2-minute silence to reflect upon those who've made the ultimate sacrifice on our behalf. Whilst we have done our utmost to pay our respects to those who have fallen, we also pay tribute to those who have fought and survived, the injured, the displaced, and of course the immediate families who have lost loved ones, not just from World War I, but in all conflicts, up to the present day. And for the people of Chorley District, we are certainly no exception. The soldiers of the Chorley Pals and the Chorley Terriers have come to epitomise World War I. But it is important to remember that men from our area also served within branches of the Royal Navy and Royal Flying Corps, later to become the RAF. And women served in many organisations that were directly supporting the war effort. Between the years 1914 to 1918, Chorley District was affected on every possible level. Single men, women, married couples, children, and the elderly were all in some way involved in the war, a war that was expected to be over by Christmas 1914. For the first time, many social barriers and prejudices were broken down to allow women to work in factories associated with the supply of munitions and military hardware. During World War I, there were great recruitment drives throughout Chorley District to encourage young men to join up and serve in the armed forces. And for the first time ever, there was a call for women to enlist and support the troops directly by way of nursing and supporting roles behind the front lines. During both World Wars, many women from our area served in uniform, and a few lost their lives, and they are commemorated on local war memorials. The men and women who served during the war earned themselves an array of service and campaign medals, and a considerable number also saw their actions rewarded with some of the country's highest honours, such as the Victoria Cross, Distinguished Service Order, and Distinguished Service Medal. And whilst we acknowledge that all those who served are heroes and heroines, the degree of medallic recognition bestowed upon our service personnel is worthy of note. Chorley District can boast two recipients of the Victoria Cross, and every bravery award available at the time of World War I and World War II was earned by at least one man from the area, as well as a number of foreign awards. There are not many villages and scarcely any towns in the United Kingdom without some form of World War memorial. Due to the unprecedented number killed in foreign fields, the dead simply couldn't be repatriated, and so they were buried close to where they fell. As a result, people back home were denied a place to grieve, pay homage, or a place for reflection. And so to cater for the needs of the bereaved, and in due course the veterans, war memorials became in essence a communal and collective headstone. Some are grander or more imposing than others, and some are very modest, but all share the same purpose, and all stand as proudly as the next. Throughout Chorley District, there are many obscure memorials, and they consist of church towers, church furniture, plaques, stained glass windows, specifically commissioned buildings, and even trees. Memorials of all shapes and sizes exist all around us. Around Chorley District, new memorials or additions to existing ones continue to be erected. Sadly, some additions are in relation to current casualties of conflict. Others are to fill unintentional omissions, such as in Adlington, where two addendum plaques were added in 2009 to add extra names to the original roll of honour. In 2015, Exton unveiled its first public memorial, which contained a roll of honour naming all the local casualties from World War I, World War II, the Falklands, and through to Afghanistan. Recently, there have also been plaques commissioned and unveiled to the Chorley Terriers and Chorley Pals of World War I. More recently, Chorley opened its Garden of Reflection in the Wall Gardens of Astley Hall, in remembrance of all those who have been affected by war, and also to acknowledge the centenary of the Armistice. Chorley District has strong ties with the armed forces, and we certainly go above and beyond in commemorating all the associated anniversaries. It is certainly not surprising when we consider that since the outbreak of World War I, and during all conflicts up to the present day, just over 2,000 men and women have made the ultimate sacrifice. With With the number of memorials that exist all around us, it helps to ensure that the people of Chorley District cannot and do not forget. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.